Hello everybody, my name's Walter and today I want to show you how you can build my ultra-precise hopper-based stopwatch. You can see here right in front of you. So basically what this thing here is, it's a standard hopper stopwatch with a maximum amount of time of roughly 2 minutes. But it has an additional sub-counter, which means that usually you have a time resolution of 4 ticks. So you just count the number of items in this hopper here, multiply it with 4 ticks and have a rough estimation of how much time has gone by. But thanks to this sub-counter here, this resolution is improved to 1 tick or 1/10 of a second. So just let's show you how this thing here works. Basically, thanks to this little converter, input converter back here, I have 3 inputs, a start button, a stop button and a reset button. And all I have to do is basically push the start button, then after a certain time I just push the stop button. And in this case I have 12 times 4 is 48, plus 0 means the whole thing has run for 48 ticks or 4.8 seconds. And that's the basic idea behind this. And now all I have to do is basically push the reset button and the whole thing starts resetting. So that's the whole thing in action. Now let's talk about the size requirements. The clock itself is 7 blocks wide, 4 blocks deep, and has a total height of 5 blocks, as you can see here. The signal converter back here, I will also show you how to build this one, adds an additional block to the top and an additional block to the back, but is actually rather compact itself and actually rather easy to use. But those are the size requirements. Now let's talk about the necessary resources. For the whole thing you will need some building blocks, then you will need some 2 glowstone blocks, or upside down slabs are also good to use. Then for redstone components you will need 11 redstone dust, 1 redstone torch, 10 redstone repeaters, 4 lamps for the sub counter, 2 sticky pistons, 2 hoppers for the main counter. And for the first increment of this tutorial we will need 2 levers. Since the clock itself is basically controlled via constant signals, and only thanks to this converter back here it can work with those 3 inputs there. But more about this in a moment. And then you will need some science to actually know what those things are actually meaning. So that's the counter or the stopwatch itself. Then for the converter I talked about, you will need an additional 2 redstone blocks, 3 slime blocks, 3 normal pistons. And then in this case I'm using buttons. Of course you can use tripwires or anything else, for example pressure plates or whatever you will need. So anyway, that's the requirements. So let's show you how to build this stopwatch here. Okay, so start by placing the front end of the whole stopwatch, simply by placing this little zigzagging structure of lamps with 2 hoppers facing into each other, as you can see here, right on top of this. Then you can already place the corresponding signs on the front. And then, now just for the records, you will need to the left 1 more block, to the right 2 more blocks, to the bottom and to the top an additional block, and that's basically the whole shadow of the whole thing here. Once you have built this front end, go to the back and start by placing 3 blocks like this, followed by 3 more blocks like that. Grab your repeaters, place 2 like this, another 2 here. Then in the opposite direction, 2 more in this direction and 2 more here. Then redstone behind them like that. Put the block up here, some redstone on top. Blocks behind those lamps here, then another block down here with some redstone on top, piston in this corner, normal block on top, block here, with a repeater on top, make sure this is on one tick, block up there, redstone on top, then grab your sticky piston and place it in between those two redstones, like that. Finally put a block in between like this. Then grab your glowstone block, place it on top of this redstone here, another block here, two more blocks right behind the two hoppers, then put redstone on top of those two blocks here, another block up there, redstone torch on top, block on top, glowstone block here, then put a redstone on top, block there, a repeater on two ticks this time, block in front, torch to this side, and finally some redstone on top of this block there. And that's the entire circuitry done. Now for the actual controls. The primary controls are those two redstone lines here. This first line, when it's activated, will start the whole clock. And this line, when it's activated, will stop or pause the whole clock. And of course, you will have to put some items in here. So if you want to have the maximum amount of time this clock can run for, which is a bit more than 2 minutes, you will have to put 5 stacks of items in this hopper here. And that's basically all. So let's show you how this thing here works. As you can see, now we have the sub-counter running and the main counter is running. And let's stop this whole thing here. And as you can see, now we have 19 times 4 plus 1, which is 77 ticks or 7.7 seconds of total time. And to reset the whole thing, I just turn off both inputs. The whole thing starts resetting. Okay, so while having two levers controlling the whole contraption might work for some of you, usually, or more probably, you will have something like pressure plates or tripwires you want to hook up with this contraption here. And in this case, you will need an additional little contraption that will translate those short signals into state changes of those inputs here. And for this, I will show you a rather simple contraption, which basically goes by placing two redstone blocks up like this, then three slime blocks, then put an upside down piston, a normal piston, like this, right on top of this redstone block here, and the same on top of any of those three slime blocks here, and then another one down just behind this sticky piston here. That's the basic setup. Then you can, in this case I'm using buttons here, place them like this, and that's the entire thing done. Now what are those different inputs? Basically, this is the start button, this is the stop button, and this is the reset button. So all I have to do to start the whole contraption is power this piston here, for example like this, then the clock starts running, then I have my second pressure plate or tripwire or whatever, and all I have to do is basically just push this bar of slime blocks down, and the entire contraption will stop. And once I have read how much time this whole thing has run, I can push the reset, and the whole thing will reset. Just like it's supposed to. So this is a rather simple way to translate short pulses into the necessary state changes to power this clock here. Okay, so that was how you can build my ultra-precise hopper-based stopwatch. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya!